So, let us solve examples. Kwa mfano, hili ni conceptual question tu la kwanza. We're having a solid sphere. Okay, solid cylinder, a hollow cylinder, a cube, all of the same mass, the same outer radius, zinakuwa released from rest of inclined and start rolling without sliding. In which order do they arrive at the bottom of the inclined plane? So in what order? So hawa wametumia approach yao, so tutatumia yetu, tutaona kama majibu yetu yafanana na wao. So we know from inclined plane the bodies are moving, ziko tatu, they are moving down. So we know the one ambayo ita accelerate faster fika huku chini, the one ambayo itafika chap, si ndio? The one ambayo itafanya fast acceleration because itakayo accelerate faster, it means itakuwa ina move the change in velocity faster, ina accelerate chap kuliko wengine, inafika mapema kuliko wengine. So tukitumia formula yetu ya acceleration, okay, hii hapa. Acceleration is sin mg sin theta divided by m plus I over r squared. Kwamba acceleration ni sawa sana 2mg sin theta, then mg sin theta divided by m plus I over r squared. So ukikompare hii acceleration to hizo bodies, mass is the same to both. G of course is a constant, the angle is a constant to both, they are using the same inclined plane, the mass is constant to both, the radius is the same to both. So kinacho change hapa between the three ni moment of inertia. So how does it relate na acceleration? So kwa kuangalia, acceleration will be big if this moment of inertia is small, because ni denominator ikiwa ndogo, it means ina divide kidogo, this value itakuwa kubwa, acceleration itakuwa kubwa. So they are inversely related. The lower the moment of inertia, the higher the acceleration. The higher the acceleration, the lower the moment of inertia, and vice versa. And therefore, tukiangalia moment of inertia ya solid sphere, solid sphere ni sawa sana 2 over 5 mr squared. Okay? Ya solid cylinder ni sawa sana a half mr squared. So for hollow cylinder inakuwa mr squared. So it means kwa kuangalia sasa, acceleration itakuwa kubwa when the moment of inertia ni ndogo. So katika ya hawa wenye moment of inertia ndogo kuliko wote ni huyu hapa, kwa sababu ana 2 over 5. Kwa huyu ndo atakuwa na acceleration ya kwanza ya kubwa kuliko wote. Anayefuatia kwa moment of inertia ndogo ni huyu mwenye half. Kwa huyu atakuwa wa pili na wa mwisho atakuwa huyu. So simple like that, ni logic tu na concept. Kule tuangalie sasa, hao wametumia njia yao, lakini eventually wamekuja kusema hapa. So since all the ships is the same mass, same change in potential energies, all final kinetic energy are equal, the objects with higher value of C will have relative here. Kwa anasema since the constant for sphere is smallest, the sphere's velocity for any given height will be largest, implying the sphere will win the race. Or as we have shown here, the sphere will be the first to reach. And therefore, the solid cylinder will come second, solid cylinder will come second, and the hollow cylinder will be the third. So hiyo ni kukumbushia tu the conceptual side of it na kuweza kuelewa what we have been doing. So we are having a body starting from rest. A sphere rolls down a 30 degrees inclined plane. What is the minimum value of coefficient of static friction if there will be no slip? Okay, so you remember that we said net force. Okay, we said net force from here. I showed you net force here, that net force is a sana mg sin theta minus the friction force. Okay, mg sin theta minus the friction force. Therefore, the net force F net itakuwa ni sana mg sin theta minus friction force. Okay, but we know net force is a sana mass times acceleration. right? The force, according to Newton's second law, is sana mass times acceleration. So divide by mass throughout, utakuja kupata acceleration ni sana g sine theta minus friction force divided by mass. Okay, so it's what ameandika hapa, friction force divided by mass. And therefore, tulisema hapa kwamba torque ni sana friction of force times the radius. Force being the tangential force, na radius being the perpendicular distance. So we can see this is the friction force and tangential, the tangential force, na perpendicular distance, which is the radius of the sphere. So we are having torque as the friction force times the radius of the sphere. But we know this is equal to, okay, angular, the angular acceleration times the moment of inertia. And therefore, from here, angular acceleration is a sign of friction force times radius divided by moment of inertia. So we have angular acceleration is a sign of friction force, the radius divided by moment of inertia. So we know that the friction force F and radius are tuna, but we have the moment of inertia of a sphere is 2 over 5 mR squared. So this R and this R will cancel, and I5 itakuja juu. Itakuwa 5F divided by 2 mR as they have shown here. Okay, 5F divided by 2 mR. But we know kwamba acceleration, linear acceleration, is a sana angular acceleration times radius. And therefore, to multiply na radius, okay, to multiply this na radius, tunai convert kwenye acceleration. So times radius, R na R will cancel, na linear acceleration A itakuwa sana 5F divided by 2 m. Okay, R na R zime cancel, kwa 5F divided by 2 m. So if we take this acceleration, tukai put hapa, kwamba hii ni sawa sana 5F divided by 2 m. Okay, 5F divided by 2 m. So if we equate the equations hapa, na tuka solve for F. Okay, tuki equate equations na tuka solve for F, tutakuja kupata F ni sawa sana 2 over 7 mg sin theta. So please do that. I know you are good in maths. Fanya tu hapo 5F divided by 2 m ni sawa sana g sin theta minus f over m. I know you are too good to miss this. Ukiamua ku multiply by 2m throughout, simplify ni wewe. So ukimfano ku multiply by 2m throughout, utakuja kupata 5f ni sawa sana 2 mg sin theta, okay, minus 2f, which is just simple. Ukileta huku inakuwa 7f ni sawa sana 2 mg sin theta. I'm doing a favor na watafunia kila kitu kweli. F ni sawa sana 2 over 7 mg sin theta. Kwa ndo hicho alichoandika 2 over 7 mg sin theta. But we know that coefficient of friction ni sawa sana the friction force divided by normal. Okay, friction force divided by normal. So the friction force tumeipata hapa kwamba ni 2 over 7 over 7 mg sin theta divided by normal. So usually normal for inclined plane, mg sio normal, sababu normal inayohitajika ni normal to the plane with which is parallel or perpendicular to the friction force, kwa sababu the plane imekuwa inclined hivi. So force ambayo iko normal, normal maana yake ni 90 degrees. So the force ambayo iko 90 degrees to the plane ni mg cos theta, and so the normal force itakuwa ni mg cos theta. Kwa mg na mg zita cancel, kwa utakuwa na 2 over 7 tan theta, basi theta ni 30, you put in the number na unakuja kupata 0.165 as the answer to our question. Various many other examples, kwa mfano hapa, calculate the final speed of a solid cylinder in a roll down 2 meter high inclined plane. The cylinder starts from rest, it has a mass of that, and has a radius of that. So calculate the final speed. So approach tukitumia ile, remember tulivyo derive concept, tulisema maximum potential energy on top ni sawa sana kutoka kinetic energy down there. So this is the final speed down there, kunakuwa na both linear na angular. So we are supposed to calculate and solve for v. We know w squared sawa sana v squared divided by r. Tunarudia tu kama v squared divided by r squared kama tulivyo derive vile vile. So you put v squared divided by r squared, and we know moment of inertia of a solid cylinder is sana half mr squared. Okay, kwa ni a half times moment of inertia of a solid cylinder, half mr squared times w squared ambayo ni v squared divided by r. So if we simplify mass throughout, we cancel mass throughout, tutapata gh ni sasa na half v squared plus a quarter. Okay, v squared. Okay, so we put some there, inakuwa ni gh ni sasa na 3 over 4 v squared, manake v ni sasa na 4 gh divided by 3 from here square root yake. We have g, we have the height as 2 meters over 3. Putting the numbers unapata jibu. In other words, you could just use the formula ambayo tulipata hapa. Okay, kwamba v ni sasa na 2 mg sin theta ya s. Sasa sin theta ya s, you remember, ndo h. Okay, sin theta ya s, you remember, ni h. Kwa ni 2 mg h divided by m plus I over r squared. Kwa tungeitumia hiyo, tungepata the same. Lakini advantage kwamba tumepata fursa ku recap na kurudia kile ambacho tulikuwa tumefanya kwenye ku derive mwanzo. So we are having a solid sphere with a mass of 5.5 and radius of that starts from rest at the height of 2.1 above the base of the inclined plane in a roll down without sliding, no friction force under the influence of gravity. What is the linear speed of the center of mass of the sphere just as it leaves the inclined and rolls on the horizontal surface? It is just simple. We use the same formula. Ya v ni sasa na 2mg divided by 2mg sin theta s, ambayo ni sin theta s ni h divided by m plus I over r squared. So we just put in the numbers hapo kwamba v ni sasa na 2gh divided by m plus I over r squared. Basi we have 2 is a constant, g ni constant 9.8 h tumepewa. Okay, 2.1 divide mass ya tumepewa, moment of inertia kwa solid sphere ni 2 over 5. Okay, mr squared. So if we put 2 over 5, kwa mfano hii I over r squared, tukisema ni 2 over 5 mr squared divide by r squared. R squared na r squared zinakufa kwa 2 over 5 m. 2 over 5 m plus 1 m. Kwa hiyo put in the numbers, sababu zote masses unazo, just put, tumbukiza tu namba huko mzee, ukiweka unapata jibu ni hilo. So that is the linear speed of which center of mass has just as it leaves and rolls on the horizontal surface. So imeongezea tu hapa kwamba if the sphere did not roll but instead it can slide down the inclined plane without friction, the final speed would be just 2gh. Okay, the final speed will just be 2gh because there will be no rotational motion. You know hichi hivi ambavyo viko chini hapa ni kwa sababu ya rotational motion. Okay, ni kwa sababu ya rotational motion. So kama ingekuwa it does not roll, kumbuka hapa amesema it rolls. Kwa tunapokuwa tuna derive hapa mwanzo, tuna consider hii angular velocity. Okay, na angular kinetic energy. Okay, rotational kinetic energy. So if it did not roll, ingekuwa ina slide tu, maana yake ingekuwa ni linear motion pure. Okay, kwa hiyo isingekuwepo. Kwa hapa v ingekuwa ni sawa sana square root ya 2gh, ndio hicho anachokisema hapa. But here swali lilikuwa linasema it rolls down without sliding. Okay, there was no sliding, so it was rolling. When a slide tungefanya hivi. So hiyo ni important notice to note. Kwa as far as the question is concerned, what is the linear speed of the center of mass? Okay, just as it leaves and rolls on the horizontal surface ni hii hapa. Okay, so if the sphere did not roll, it can slide tu peke yake without friction, the final speed ingekuwa just 2gh na ungepata hii. So that's the difference. So this is our answer. We have other many examples. Well, from the University of Durham, you have a uniform solid ball rolls down the slope. The ball has a diameter of 0.5 meters and a mass of that. Find the equation which describes the velocity of the ball at any time, given that it starts from rest. Clearly state any assumptions you make. So, tunafanya vile vile kwamba potential energy maximum, sasa sana kinetic energy mv squared. So you repeat the same process ambayo tulifanya ku derive. So the assumption made as they've shown here that we have pure rolling without any sliding. So another question B is that if the slope has inclined at 30 to the horizontal, what is the speed of the ball after it travels 3 meters? So we know that the formula says v ni sawa sana. Okay. Inasema ni sawa sana 2mg sin theta s on 2mg sin theta times s divided by m plus I over r squared. So you put in the numbers. Yeah, you put in the numbers. So these are the cases where sin theta s itakusaidia kwa sababu hauna height. Okay, hauna height, so inabidi utumie tu sin theta s. So you have a constant 2 mass imepewa 0.1 g is a constant, sin the angle is 30, s ndo distance ya travel. So sio height, ni distance ya travel kutoka mwanzo incline mpaka mwisho, length ya plane s. Okay, you remember when we were deriving, so ndo 3 meters divided by mass. Unayo moment of inertia, we know for a uniform ball is as if ni solid sphere, kwa inakuwa 2/5. Okay, inakuwa ni 2/5 mr squared. So like that, you put in the numbers, the radius unayo umepewa 0.5, umepewa the diameter, so the radius will be half of that. Okay, itakuwa half of that. So remember that you put that there in there, and unakuja kupata your answer as 4.58 meters per second. So try and see. Another question at this point, what is the angular momentum of the ball? So we know angular momentum is sana IW. The I we know 2/5 mr squared. So it's what they have been doing here, 2/5 mr squared. W we know ni V over R. So we have the V here ambayo tumeipata. Radius yake ni 0.25, okay, because this is the diameter. And therefore, we put in the numbers 2/5, hiyo na hiyo, cancel 2/5, m, r, v equal 2/5, m 0.1, v tulipata hapo, radius ni 0.25 hapo. The diameter, we put in the numbers, tunapata, and the moment, the angular momentum is 0.0458 kilograms, So, final question, we have the coefficient. If the coefficient of friction between the ball and slope is given by 0.26, what is the maximum angle of inclination the slope could have and still allows the ball to roll? Tumeshafanya a similar question here, if you remember, the coefficient of friction to the pattern is 2/7 tan theta. So, we will repeat here, just in case for your benefit. So, we have net force, which is mass times acceleration, is given by mg sine theta minus friction force divided by mass throughout, takuwa hivyo. Okay, but we know that acceleration a ni sawa sana angular acceleration times radius, and therefore we can put this ni sawa sana angular acceleration times radius. But we know that the torque for this case ni sawa sana friction force times the radius. Kembo ni sasa na moment of inertia, sasa na moment of inertia times the angular acceleration. And therefore, angular acceleration is sasa na friction force times radius over I. So, this itakuwa ni sasa na friction force times radius divided by moment of inertia is 2/5 mr squared. Okay, 2/5 mr squared. So that r squared and r squared cancels. 4/5 itakuja juu, kwa utakuwa na 5/2 m times friction force. This is what we have for angular, okay, this is what we'll have for utabaki na r, because r ina cancel na r moja, so utakuwa na friction 5 inakuja juu 2mr we'll have for angular acceleration. So if we put it here, ni sawa sawa na angular acceleration ni sawa sawa na 5 over 2 friction force times r over m r, so that r na r cancel, utabaki na fr over m ni sawa sawa na g sin theta minus m. So g sin theta minus fr m. So if you decide to multiply by m throughout, itakuwa ni mg, m na m is the cancel. So finally, utabaki na mg sin theta ni sawa sawa, if you take fr the other side, kuna 5 over 2 fr. Kwa hiyo you add that, itakuwa ni 1 plus 5 over 2. Okay. Fr. Kwa manake e 1 plus 5 over 2, 5 over 2 ni 2.5. So plus 1 inakuwa ni 3.5. Kwa 3.5 itakuja hapa. So ukiangalia hii 3.5 ni sawa sawa na 7 over 2. Kwa hiyo ni sawa sawa na 7 over 2. So 2 inapanda juu inakuwa 2 over 7 mg sin theta. Kwa hiyo ni friction force. But we know coefficient of friction ni sawa sawa na friction force of a normal reaction. Na tulishasema normal reaction kwenye inclined plane ni force ambayo iko perpendicular to the plane, ambayo ni mg cos theta and not mg. Kwa maana yake friction force ni divided by normal reaction ambayo ni mg cos theta. Kwa mg na mg itakuwa sin theta over cos theta ni tan theta. Kwa 2 over 7 tan theta. So coefficient of friction itakuwa ni 2 over 7 tan theta. Kwa ambayo wamefanya hapa. Coefficient of friction 2 over 7 tan theta. So tumepa coefficient of friction as 0.26. Okay, 0.26. So 5 inakuwa 0.26 times 7 divided by 2. 0.26 times 7 ndio unapata 0.91. Tafuta tan inverse. Remember to put your calculator in degrees. Okay, remember to put your calculator in degrees. Otherwise ukiweka in radians unapata jibu la ajabu. Unapata the angle in degrees ambayo ni 42.3 degrees. So our final question, we have a ball here of mass 0.2 kilograms in each of four, but I hope you can see, in radius of 0.5, starting from rest in a roll down 30 degrees inclined plane. Find the time it would take to cover 7 meters and calculate the torque acting at the end of 7 meters. So we know the formula acceleration ambayo tulikuwa nayo. Okay, ilikuwa inasema kwamba kwamba acceleration ni hiyo umeweka mbwembwe tu hapa, kwamba acceleration ni sawa sana mg sin theta, fanya kwetu ambao sisi tumezoea m plus I over r squared. So this is a ball, is a sphere, so you can have, you have the mass 0.2 kilograms, you have g sin theta, the angle is 30, the mass we have, the moment of inertia of a ball ni 2 over 5 mr squared. So put in the numbers, unapata moment of inertia divided by r squared, tunapata acceleration. Okay, tunakuja kupata acceleration ni 3.5, okay, meters per second squared. So finally, we know from Newton's second equation of motion, s is equal to ut plus a half at squared. Initial is zero, so s we are having it as 7 meters, you are told to cover 7 meters. Kiambiwa tu to cover a certain number of meters. So kwa mfano hapa it travels 3 meters. Kumbuka hiyo ni horizontal velocity, not the height. So you have s as 7, we have the acceleration hapo, so you can solve for t kama ambavyo umefanya hapo, kwamba t ni sawa na square root ya 2s, okay, divided by acceleration ambayo tayari tunayo. Square root of that, unapata this 2 seconds. So the final question is to calculate the torque acting at the end of 7 meters. So we know kwamba torque ni sawa sawa na moment of inertia times angular acceleration. Okay, moment of inertia times angular acceleration. Moment of inertia is 2 over 5 mr squared. The angular acceleration is sawa sawa na linear acceleration divided by the radius. We have all this. Mass, the radius, the acceleration to the pattern, the radius tunayo, and we put in the numbers tunakuja kupata jibu. So as far as this translational rotational interface, the relationship is concerned, those are the questions we have.